published 1730 Eastern Standard Time, 11 November 2017 updated 1730 Eastern Standard Time, 11 November 2017 for Kyle Lafferty, there was no hiding place. On the football pitch, he was surrounded by a betting culture. Away from it, he gambled on horses, dogs, roulette, anything. Even in Switzerland, he couldn't resist having a wager on games of ice hockey. That was during a year spent at FC Sion in 201213 on loan from Rangers, where a gambling addiction had truly taken hold. Lafferty is back playing in Scotland with Hearts and back in Switzerland on Sunday for the second leg of Northern Ireland's World Cup playoff tie in Basle, having decided to confront his demons. Kyle Lafferty opened up about his battle with an addiction to gambling in his career. The Northern Irishman believes it is a problem suffered by many professional footballers. 30-year-old former Norwich and Burnley striker can talk openly about the problems that threaten to engulf his career, and, he believes, remain a major issue in football. To be out gambling, you need time and money. Footballers have both, says Lafferty. You finish training at 1 o'clock, and you have all afternoon and all evening to yourself. It's difficult if you are in that environment and you get tips sent to you. Everywhere you look, there is something to do with betting. In Scotland, it's the William Hill Cup and the Ladbrokes Premier League. You're playing a game and BET 365 is going around advertising boards and stuff like that. You can't get away from it. And the SPFL get money from bookies who advertise. I think people need to look at it. I've spent about 11 years where probably only my close pals and teammates knew about the problem. Even they probably didn't know to what extent it was. I'm glad I've come out. I've heard people say I did it for sympathy, but that's rubbish. I'm doing it for myself to get over this addiction that has been a massive part of my career. Once I'm over it, I want to help others. Lafferty's problem dates back to playing on slot machines growing up in Cash, County Fermanagh. It reached crisis point last year when he was fined £23,000 by the FA for betting on two football games in Spain. His honesty was reflected in a lenient punishment, but he could easily have been banned from playing for Northern Ireland at Euro 2016. It got to a stage where I was lying about what I was doing, he admits. I had to get help or let my career go downhill. I was asked if it affected my football, and I can't say if it did or didn't, because there hasn't been a time as a professional footballer when I haven't gambled or had an addiction. I played with a weight on my shoulders. Lafferty thinks footballers are susceptible due to the amount of free time and money they have. He was betting on anything: horses, dogs, virtual racing, roulette. I knew absolutely nothing about horses. I would go by the color of the jersey or the name. It was every day on the horses, and every single race. When I was over in Switzerland, I was betting on ice hockey, which was on every single day and night. A move to Hearts in the summer after three frustrating years at Norwich has helped Lafferty to address his issues. He confided in coach Austin McPhee, a friend he knew well from the Northern Ireland setup. He spoke to the Sporting Chance Clinic and had counseling sessions in London. Hearts manager Craig Levane, owner and budget, and Northern Ireland boss Michael O'Neill have supported him. So too John Hartson, the former Celtic and Arsenal striker who has faced his own battle with gambling. No one knows how stressful it is unless you are in that environment and you have that addiction, says Lafferty. I was embarrassed to come out at first. I was afraid that people would judge me or look down on me. Speaking to John made me feel better. He believes golf and meetings have helped him to fight his gambling addiction. He was at a Georgia Gamblers Anonymous meeting last Wednesday with him. A guy picked up his 35-year pin. He's been to every single meeting, two a week. I spoke to him after and asked him why so long. He said, "You need to do it. You need as much help as you can, and there are lots of people who are helping me, and then there will be others who will want me to fail. I finally got my mind in the right place, and I'm not going to let anyone else jump on the bandwagon and slag me off. I'm going to do this for my family and myself." Lafferty has settled just outside East Kilbride with his model wife Vanessa in the house they bought before getting married in May last year. He is happy at Hearts and has scored 9 goals already this season. Golf has also helped him keep the demons at bay. "I'm willing to do anything, as long as it gets me away from being in the house by myself," he says. "If I have to be in a bunker for half a day, rather than being in the bookies, I'll do that."